You don't want to make light, and we hope it isn't serious, but that's why communication is key. David Jacoby, each of us have a mobile device that we keep very near and dear to us. So many of us even take it to the bathroom with us. Okay, so what ends up happening in scenarios like this, they're reaching out to you, texting you, mm-hmm. coaches, assistant coaches, and then they start reaching out to your team to see where you are, and they start to realize that you're not responding. Initially, when I saw that he was gonna miss the game, I saw that it was for rest. And then I realized it was for personal reasons. And so again, what makes this more for the spotlight is that it was a nationally televised game. Mm-hmm. The league frowns upon resting and uninjured players missing nationally televised games. So lastly, it seems like that press conference was at 10:30, 11 o'clock. Cause I was watching Caris LeVert and Harris do work. And Steve Nash was at the podium. And did he say he hadn't talked to him yet?
Hadn't talked to him. Jalen, we have exclusive footage. You know it was blowing up. Look, you got Steve Nash texting him. He got 20 missed calls from Sean Marks and GM. Look at Kevin Durant's hitting him up. Like, our player. Like, how do you not know? How do you not know? I've never played in the NBA. You have. How do you not know where your star player is and why he's not at the game?
Communication is key. And what also takes place is they have two elite level players. Well, all players should be treated fair, Jacoby, but not equal. When you're talented like Kyrie Irving and you can get buckets versus anybody like you are short Kevin Durant, people are gonna tolerate you not calling back. But the other problem with that is now everybody calling KD. Like, where your man?
What's up with your man?
Like on
what's
belly.
Your man's at?
That's your man. That's your man. And he like, yo, you know what I'm saying? I'm trying to quarantine. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to be back out there. Let me hit him. You know what I'm saying? So I'll hit him. You know what I'm saying? And then you know what? Kyrie picked right up for him. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, he picked right up.
Yeah, he got 20 missed calls from Sean Marks. KD calls. He's like, wait, what's up? What's going on? KD's like, where are you at? He's like, oh, we had a game tonight? We didn't get tonight. Oh, my bad. My bad.
But at least they won.
He's going to drop 40 in the next game. He's going to drop 40 in the game after that. And everyone's going to forget that he just straight up didn't show up to work one day. Because that's how Kyrie gets down. And this is how we get down. We will continue to preview. He is Jalen Rose. I am David Jacoby. We are Jalen Jacoby. Jalen, what is it exactly that we do?
We give the people what they want.
It is here. Wild Card Weekend. Super Wild Card Weekend.
Are
look at all these games. I am not going to see my family all weekend long because I'll be drinking beers and watching football. And look at all the games that we have to watch. And we start with where the action will start on Sunday. That is my favorite game of the weekend between the Ravens and the Titans. And it features someone who has found his swagger, Lamar Jackson. If you haven't noticed, Lamar Jackson is back to his MVP form. Will he continue against the Titans?
Put some respect on my guy Lamar's name. Mm-hmm. I know Aaron Rodgers may be the MVP this year. I know Patrick Mahomes was Super Bowl MVP last year, but that guy right there is the reigning league MVP. And we don't want to see him lose in the first game of the playoffs, Jacoby.
No.
It's going to be imperative for them to be able to run the football and for him to be able to hit throws down the field. Hollywood Brown got to make some big plays. And this team really struggles if they get down. It's important for them to get off to a really good start. They haven't fared well in games where Lamar is the starting quarterback when they've gotten behind.
Do you remember last year when they were cruising, Lamar was the MVP, and he had the chain on during the game in week 17? I want that Lamar back. And let me tell you why these Ravens are going to win. The Ravens are going to win, and here is why. Take a look at these defensive numbers. We know that both of these teams can run the ball, But the Ravens can stop the run and the Titans can't. That right there on the screen is going to be the key to this game. And they will be able to stop the unstoppable force that is Derrick Henry, especially late in the season and in the playoffs. Do you think they can stop that man right there?
Do you think somebody would snatch Derrick Henry's chain during the game?
I don't. No.
Because they'll get stiff-armed just like that. They ain't gonna get close enough to even try. But he's got to be a key. Of course, he ran for 2,000 yards this year. But what actually was a surprise last year was the play of Ryan Tannehill. He's got to be crucial in order for them to find a way to eliminate the Ravens. That's why I, like you, feel like the Ravens D is going to stand up. Lamar's going to have a huge day, and the Ravens and John Harbaugh will advance.
Jalen, you know I'm a die easy fan. I just pick teams every season, decide to jump on their bandwagon. And before the season even started, I jumped on the Bills bandwagon, and I've been riding that thing so hard. I am now officially not just part of the minivan mafia, but also part of the Bills mafia. There I am right there, lifelong Bills fan, and I guarantee that the Bills will beat the Colts this weekend, and they will do so because of a gentleman by the name of Josh Allen, and if available, Stephon Diggs. Allen to Diggs has been such a good connection, probably the best connection in the NFL, in my opinion. What do you think about these two this weekend?
Been outstanding this year. Record-breaking in the history of the Bills organization, and that said a lot for a team that went to four straight Super Bowls and got multiple Hall of Famers. But did we just do a Photoshop of you and the Bills Mafia? And
that's
I didn't see a member of...
I'm part of the Bills Mafia. Not a Photoshop.
All right.
No, that's me. That's actually me.
Okay. Can I ask you a question? Members of Griselda at?
They're extremely disappointed. They're behind me right there.
No Benny the Butcher?
Conway's right behind me.
He got the theme song.
Conway's behind the flag right there.
Where's West Side Gun?
Well, the only thing that could impede the Bills' march toward the Super Bowl is a gentleman by the name of Jonathan Taylor. Jonathan Taylor has really found himself the second half of this season. Do you think he can find the same success he had last week, this week against the Bills?
I had him on my fantasy team this year. He nice. Saw him ball in college. Unfortunately, on the wrong uniform in the Big Ten. And I knew that he was going to be a stud, three-down type of running back when he got to the NFL. He has to be a game changer. But also, they got a seasoned veteran under center. It's going to come down to the arm of Phillip Rivers, Jacoby. Can he play mistake-free football?
There's one game this weekend that I'm looking at and thinking, you know what? Maybe this is the game I spent some time with my family. Because there's one game I'm looking at that looks like a blowout. And one game that looks like a blowout. And that is the game between the NFC West Rams and Seahawks. I know who's playing quarterback for the Seahawks. I don't know who's playing quarterback for the Rams. I don't know who's going to play quarterback for the Rams. I see this one as a blowout. How can the Rams possibly make this an upset?
It's hard for me to think of a squad that has Aaron Donald and Jalen on it, and you think they're going to get blown out?
I think so.
Seriously?
I think so.
I'll tell you what. If Carson is running the football and gives Russell Wilson some balance, and they're able to hit some deep balls to Metcalf and to Lockett because they've been outstanding in doing so, then your prediction may be correct. But I believe you're saying that because, like you mentioned, one team has that guy, Russell Wilson, and you're not sure who's going to be on the center for the Rams.
No idea. Here's what's happening right now at his hotel room. Jalen Ramsey's outside DK Metcalf's hotel room right now. He's just standing outside the door. He could be following DK Metcalf everywhere he goes. When he goes to get lunch, when he gets on the bus, when he gets to the facility. Like, Jalen Ramsey is following DK Metcalf right now as we speak on Friday, even though the game is on Saturday afternoon. But I think this one will be Seahawks, and I think that maybe, potentially, during the second half, I will have time to eat dinner with my family. The only time my family will see my face all weekend long. Now, Jalen Anthony Rose, there's something that happened in the NBA that I really need your insight on. Only you can explain this to us. We need you to take us behind the curtain. I don't even know how to explain this. I'm just going to let the head coach.